This is an excerpt from the Browning version. The scene is set in a school. Frank is a young, and Crocker Harris is a middle-aged teacher. Taplow is a boy of 16 who has come in to do extra work for Crocker Harris. But the latter has not yet arrived, and Frank finds Taplow waiting. So here goes their conversation.
Do I know you?
No, sir.
What's your name?
Taplow.
Taplow? No, I don't know. You are not a scientist, I gather.
No, sir. I am still in lower fifth. I can't specialize until next term. That's to say, if I have my removal all right.
Don't you know whether you have got your removal?
No, sir. Mr. Crocker Harris doesn't tell us the results like other masters.
Why not?
Well, sir, you know what he is like.
I believe that there is a rule that form results should be announced only by the headmaster on the last day of term.
Yes, sir, but no one else pays attention to it except Mr. Harris.
I admit, but there is no criteria, so you have got to wait until tomorrow to know your fate, have you?
Yes, sir.
Suppose the answer is favorable then?
Oh, science. Of course, sir.
Yes, we get all the slackers.
I'm extremely interested in science.
Are you? I'm not. Not at least in the science I have to teach.
Well, anyway, sir, it's a good deal. More exciting than this muck.
What is muck?
Stylus, sir. This Agamemnon.
And your conceited view is that the Agamemnon is muck?
No, sir. I don't think it's muck exactly. Actually, it's really a great plot. A wife murdering her husband and all. I only meant the way it is taught. Just lots of Greek words together and 50 lines if we get them wrong.
You sound a little bitter, Taplow.
I'm rather, sir.
Capped in?
No, sir. Extra work.
Extra work? On the last day?
Yes, sir. And I might be playing golf. You think he has enough to do anyway himself? But considering that he is leaving tomorrow for good, oh no, I missed that day last week when I was ill, so I'm here now. And look at the weather, sir.
Bad luck. Still there is one comfort. You are pretty well setting to get your move tomorrow from being a good boy.
Well, I'm not sure, sir. That would be true of the ordinary masters. Because they won't dare to give a chap a remove after taking his extra work. But those sort of rules doesn't apply on the croc. Mr. Crocker Harris, do you know, I asked him yesterday that he did give me a remove, and do you know what he said, sir?
No. What?
My dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve. No more, no less. I think he may have marked me down rather than up for taking extra work. The man's hardly human. Sorry, sir. Have I gone too far?
Yes, much too far.
Sorry, sir. I got carried away.
Have you entered the club?
Yes, sir.
What was that Crocker Harris said to you? Just repeat it, would you?
My dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve. No more, no less.
Not in the least like him. Read your nice book and be quiet.
As Kylus?
Look, what did Mr. Crocker Harris tell you to be here?
6:30, sir.
Well, he's 10 minutes late. Why don't you cut? You could still play golf before lockup.
Oh, no, I couldn't cut the croc, Mr. Crocker Harris. I don't think it's ever been done the whole time he's been here. God knows what would happen if I did. He did probably follow me home or something.
I must admit, I envy him the fact he seems to have on you boys. You all seem scared to death of him. What does he do? Beat you all or something?
Good Lord, no. He's not a sadist. Like one or two of the others.
I beg your pardon.
Sadist, sir. Someone who gets pleasure out of giving pain.
Indeed, but I think you went on to say that some other masters.
Well, of course, sir. I won't mention name, but you know them well. Of course, I know that most of the masters think that we boys don't understand a thing. But sir, you are different. You are young. And comparatively, you are science. You must know what sadism is.
Good Lord, what are our school coming to?
Anyway, the croc is not a sadist. He won't be so frightening if he were. Because at least it would show that he had some feelings, but he has not. He is all shriveled up inside like a nut and seems to hate people. It's funny, I don't know any other master who don't like being liked.
And I don't know any boy who don't use that for own purpose.
It's natural, sir, but not with the croc.
Mr. Crocker Harris.
Mr. Cocker Harris, the funny thing is that in spite of everything, I do rather like him. I can't help it. And sometimes I think that he sees it and that seems to shrivel him up even more.
I am sure you are exaggerating.
No, sir, I am not. And from the other day, he made his one of the classical jokes. And of course, no one laughed because no one understood. Myself included. Still, I knew it. He meant it as funny. So I laughed and feeling a bit sorry for his poor joke. Now I can't remember what joke was. But suppose I make it. Now you laugh, sir. Tablo, you have laughed at my joke? I noticed. I must confess that you have advanced your Latin. Perhaps now you would be good enough to explain it to them so that they can share your pleasure.
The door upright is pushed open and Millie Crocker Harris enters. She's a thin woman in her late 30s, rather more smartly dressed than the general run of schoolmasters' wives. She's wearing a cap and carries a shopping basket. She closes the door and then stands up the scene, watching Taplo and Frank conversating. It is a few seconds before they noticed her.
Come along, Taplo. Do not be so selfish as to keep a good joke to yourself. Tell the others. Oh, Lord. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Do you think she heard?
I think she did. She was standing there quite a time.
If she didn't tell him, there goes my remove.
Nonsense.
Waiting for my husband?
Yes.
He is at the bus, sir, and might be there quite a time. If I were you, I would go.
He said most particularly I was to come.
Well, why don't you run away for a quarter of an hour and come back?
Supposing he gets here before me?
I will take the blame. I tell you what. You can do a job for him and take this prescription to the chemist and get it.
All right, Mrs. Crocker Harris.